There is nothing I desire compared with you. Abba Father, we thank you for the privilege of coming before your presence again. Hallowed be your name, O God, for celebration of life. Be thou exalted, O God, for that you said to do, even this Sunday. Thank you, my God and my Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Congratulations that the Lord brought you into another Sunday again. And I want to say a happy Sunday to you. The Lord will keep you. The Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus. You're going to see celebrate Christmas and see 2022 beyond in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If you are the one, say amen. If you believe, say I believe. Hallelujah. Now, quickly, I want to continue on the message I started on Thursday. Like I said on Thursday, I didn't finish the message. I just paused in order to continue. Anything you pause, that means you can press it and continue. And so that's what we're going to do. But today we're going to look more and go deeper on the topic, choosing for favor. Choosing for favor. And this is going to be part two of it, choosing for favor. Now let me take my text from the book of Psalm, chapter 102, verse 15. Psalm 102, verse 15. Now let me just take it from verse 13. It says, thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion for the set time to favor her. Yea, the set time has come. Thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion for the set time to favor her has come. And some say, some school of thought said that this is the time where David was running away from Saul, and there was trouble in his heart, and he began to write that, oh Lord, thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion, for the set time to favor her has come. When we meet, the set time is the appointed time of God. Everyone have an appointed time of God for God to meet him or to reach him. It does not matter how long you've been there without a baby as a married couple. There's a set time God appointed. If you believe God, there's a time he has appointed to meet you. Thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion. You can put your name there upon Francis Etsy. For the time to favor me, yea, the set time has come. And the beginning said in verse 14, for the servant take pleasure in her stones and favor the doors thereof. So the heathen shall fear the names of the Lord, and all the kings of the earth that glory, whom the Lord shall build upon Zion. He shall appear in his glory. When the Lord favors you, he will appear in his glory, that men will see that this is God. And let me begin by saying, as we look on the topic, choosing for favor, that life without God's favor is a hard life. I repeat again, life without God's favor is hard life. I can imagine a man going all through his years, 70 years, not one favor of a come to him. That is hard life. When you see someone who have living a hard life, you don't need to ask him questions. It's all well with you. You can see the way he dress. You can see his hair. You can see everything about his skin, that this man have lived a hard life. In Songs of Solomon and the Lamentation, it said that our skin are black. I think Lamentation chapter 4. Our skin are black. When you see a man who lack God's favor, his skin become black. It got to do with complexion. So how a life without God's favor leads to a hard life. And that is not your portion. I don't prophesy hard life to you. I prophesy God's favor to you that will make you leap for joy. Now, favor of God bring joy, bring happiness to our heart. When you are favored, all where you go, there's rejoicing, peace in your heart. You begin to dance, you begin to smile. Now, a man and a woman who is highly favored by God, he don't need to be moody. No, he can see his countenance that something good is happening to him. It's like a man who won lottery. For example, if you are a student and you have all A's in your exam, I tell you, work out there with boldness. you can go and give your parents your card. You are bold to give them. In those days, when we're growing up in those days, a child who fails his or her son, when he comes home, he hides his result or her result. The parents say, where is the result? He said, I'm looking for it. I'm looking for it. Why was he looking for it? Because he knows they're going to prove, not to show. But a son, a child who have all A's, in fact, if we carry the report card before he enter, he will announce it to his parent. The Lord is about to announce you because of the favor of God that is coming upon you in this month of November. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, it does not matter. I don't want to care how long you've been struggling, but the favor of God is coming upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. The favor of God call with timing. The favor of God call with timing. That when they will say, thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion, for the set time to favor her. It call with timing, because we say the appointed time for favor. And so the favor of God here is call with timing. In Greek, timing is called kairos. Now, what is kairos? Kairos really means God's divine intervention in our life to accelerate or bring to pass some occurrence or event that will please us. Kairos means you say, Lord, let your kairos come now, let your timing come now, so that he can bring everything, every pleasure that want in my life that will make me rejoice. Thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the set time to favor her has come. I'm so glad that I am reaching out to you today. I don't know the platform you are watching me from, but I'm so glad that favor of God is coming upon you. That there's a man that you having a pain in your feet, in your foot, in your right foot. I'm telling you right now, after this finish watching, you're gonna jump up like this, and you see that pain is gone. Hallelujah. I can feel it now. I can feel it. Praise Jesus. So chaos is an unexpected, unscheduled, and unexplainable when God decides to favor you. It just comes suddenly. Like healing comes suddenly. Like this man, your healing just came suddenly. See some woman who believe in God for foot and wall for 3 years, for 5 years, for 7 years, 8 years, 10 years, and she suddenly become pregnant. That's chaos. Yeah. Suddenly they just get a car. That's chaos. Or somebody they just get an appointment, that's chaos. Or somebody they just get a visa, who they be believing God for, that's chaos. There's an expected, there's an appointed time that God will meet you, and this is the time. Thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion, for the set time to favor her have come. In Daniel chapter 1, verse 9. Now God brought Daniel. He brought him from dungeon. He brought him from slave, because these are slave boys. These are men who they took from Babylon, who they took from Jerusalem to Babylon. So he said, now God has brought Daniel into favor, in his strange life, into favor. And Daniel with the princess, with the prince of Enoch. God brought him. This is a man that's going to be a domestic worker. He said, but Bible said that God brought him. When he said now, means something happened before. If you read the previous something happened before, that God brought Daniel into favor. God is bringing you into favor. I don't know where you are right now. You could be like Mephibosheth in Lodabar, but God is bringing you into favor. You could be in a place where nobody wants to visit you, but God is bringing you into favor. You could be in a place where everyone have rejected, they dump you, and they say nothing comes out of you, but God is bringing you to favor. Where you are, it could be Mara, but God is going to turn your life to be sweet now, in the mighty name of Jesus. So I declared, and God will affirm it. Bible said that Daniel was promoted over other Babylonians in the kingdom. Imagine Daniel as a citizen, an alien, in Finland, but here he was promoted above people, citizen. That is favor of God. He was chosen by favor. Because there are other people, citizens of Babylon, who should be prime minister, who should be second in command. But this man worked in foreign regime. Why? He was chosen for favor. When God chooses you for favor, everything becomes work according to the plan of God and purpose who have created you. I've seen people who have all their years, they don't struggle. From their womb, favor follow them. So everything they do, they find it easy. They find it easy to do. Why? Because of the favor of God. Favor of God is coming upon you like an avalanche. It's going to clothe, it's going to tabernacle you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So Daniel was promoted above other people. Even though the circumstances where Daniel found himself was so bad, was so dejected, but yet God sought him out and he became the prime minister in Israel land. Every government changed hand, they will keep him. Every government moved, they keep recommending him to another government. It's the word of God. You know, we live in a time whereby people are so biased, they don't care how qualified you are in your profession. In politics, for example, now when the president or whatever, the prime minister, whatever they call it in your country that you are serving, immediately they leave power, the new one come, he will first of all sweep everyone away and bring his own people. That is not good. That is not of God. That's their qualification. No. There are people who deliver, so it's hard to keep them in the office. But Daniel was so relevant. When a person is choosing for a position, he or she did not naturally qualify amongst other people, that is what we call the choosing by favor. Choosing by favor. You could see God at work. Like what we saw in our part one of this message, that Esther was choosing above other women. Esther was like Daniel, also, who was in his strange land. He was not worthy to even appear in the palace, but yet become the first lady. Ooh, hallelujah. It does not matter that person that they dump you and your relationship have crashed out. Hear me and hear me well. God is bringing the champion. God is bringing that man that's so worthy, that is going to carry like egg, that will treat you like a queen in the mighty name of Jesus. And that is the portion. David also was the most unqualified person among the sons of Jesse. But somehow, favor came and chose him and rejected the others. People who think they are qualified for position, but favor makes you that is not qualified to drop them, to pass them. It is your season for favor. To be chosen by God is to be favored by men. To be chosen by God is to be favored by man. Now, here is what favor does. Favor does not ask for repayment. That, you know, when one favors you and maybe buy you a car, he's not buying that car so that he can be a servant for him. No. Favor does not seek for repayment. Does not seek for repayment. They just do it because God commanded them to do it. Jabez was also favored by God, and he was chosen among others. His name came briefly in the Bible. I just talked about two verses in the Bible that he talked about Jabez. But all through the life of Jabez, it was capitalized with struggle until he prayed. Today we're going to take some prayer before end of the telecast, that God will turn this around. Turn this around. And a hero will be favored. Life sometimes is not actually by duration, but by a donation. Life is not about duration, it's by donation. What have you achieved? What have God used you to do? You just made to say that? You are begging people. When I see people begging people, 70 years, you see a burden to people, you are a challenge to society. 50 years, you see a challenge to society. No, you need to cry to God. If you are watching me right now and you are even above 25 years, you need to cry to God. Oh God, favor me early. Favor me early. Let your favor come upon me so early, Lord. Early in life, will you satisfy me, God? David was saying, let the bone favor me, Lord, that the bone that created me may rejoice in it. The favor of God. You are chosen by favor. So you need to know what God is saying right now concerning your situation. Never use your hand to cancel the favor of God. When you please God, God will cause men to please you. Hallelujah. Another man was favored by God, was chosen by God, was Jephthah. He was, according to my friend Apostle Ono Abada, he said Jephthah was discounted, but later he was counted. That's what favor does. He was discounted. He said, we don't want you. But yet, when he was chosen by favor, he was counted. He become a joy. He become their ruler. He become their leaders. Hallelujah. So we need to ask the Lord, oh Lord, it is my time for favor. When you get a help from the corridor that you didn't expect help to come from, that is favor, chosen by favor. You didn't expect a breakthrough from there. You didn't expect for you to get tender from there. You didn't expect to get it from there. And when it comes, that is God at work. Mostly find favor on the backside of the bush. Because normally God shouldn't come to you when you are leading a cattle or sheep. No. It should come to people who are praying in the prayer mountain. Oh, God, use me. Oh, but this is the man who was not even praying. He was minding his business. And his business, God met him in his business. And God said, going to do my business. It's favor. So he left his business and followed God's business. He said, because I'm giving you an assignment to go to Egypt. I know you ran away from Pharaoh, but you're going to go back to Pharaoh. I said, Pharaoh, let my people go. Because God spoke to me. And he revealed himself to me that I am that I am. That sent you. Moses find favor. He was chosen in the backside of the bush. David also found favor when he was taking care of his father's sheep at the field. The Lord spotted him out and he chose it. Now, don't miss the next message. I am preaching a message called the oil of favor. We're going to see things that will shock you, that you're going to cry and pray until that oil drops upon your body, your life. The prayer we need to pray is, Lord, locate me with your favor. Locate me with your favor. That's the prayer. But before we pray, because we're going to spend some time to pray. Before we pray, if you are here, if you are watching me, you don't know Jesus. It's time for you to surrender your life to Jesus. Everyone have done it, no one is judging you, but it's time. Don't postpone it. Jesus is knocking at your door. If you can open your heart to him, he will receive you and make his son and his daughter. So if you are ready right now, you don't need to pay for it because salvation is free. You're going to say, dear Lord Jesus, just bow your head down and say after me, say, dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner that needs repentance. I declare with my mouth and my heart believe that you died and rose up again on my body. Thank you for saving me in the mighty name of Jesus. Now let me pray for you. Father, I thank you, bless your name. Thank you for this one, oh God, I've taken the decision to follow you. Lord, I ask, oh God, that you offend the world. Devil will reject you on their behalf. They will follow Jesus to the end. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, my God and my Father. In Jesus' name. Among of you who took that, someone prayed this prayer, you're having a pain here, like a muscle pull, but it comes from your neck, naked down here. Lay your hand, I'm going to pray. May constant like a pious. The right hand of God is power. I prophesy healing upon that body right now. In the name of Jesus, be healed, vain be strengthened. In the name of Jesus. Now, congratulations to those who give their life to Jesus. Please go to our website and just drop us a note that you go save. I will personally reply you and send some material that be a blessing to you. Hallelujah. So, we're going to pray right now. We're going to pray right now. And the prayer, we're going to spend some time, maybe 10 or maybe just 5 minutes to pray. We're going to call upon God. You see, Jabez called upon God, and God enlarged his course and bless him. So we're going to pray. You're going to say, my Father, as I begin to pray, you will answer me by your mercy. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, answer me by your mercy, O God. Your mercy is the medicine, O God of God. Lord, my God and my Father, I am praying and asking. Answer me by mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, your mercy, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. You're going to say, Father, as I pray right now, locate me with your favor. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, begin to pray that Lord, locate me with your favor. Locate me, locate me, locate me, locate me, locate me with your favor, Lord. Locate me with your favor. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus. Say, Father, let your supernatural favor that brings addition continue to my life. Let it begin to happen to me right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let your supernatural favor, God, that brings addition, oh God, to my life, oh God. Let it begin to happen right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Jesus' name. You're going to pray. Say, Father, let me experience uninterrupted supply. Supply, supernatural supply that I need. Uninterrupted. Not that you get one bridge to the dentist and not 3 years. No. Uninterrupted. You're going to pray. Open your mouth. I'm going to pray. Lift up your voice. I'm going to pray. Lord, send that all such favor to me. Uninterrupted, God, supply, supernatural supply. Send it to me. Send it to me. Send it to me. Send it to me. Kakoto parakata kata parakata. Leko solo koto koto parakata. Iketeke leketeke sieta. In Jesus' name, you're going to pray that, Father, cause me to walk on your favor all the days of my life. In the name of Jesus, go ahead and begin to pray that, Father, cause me to walk, oh God, in favor, on favor, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, all the days of my life, Lord, cause me to walk, oh God, in favor. Cause me to walk, oh God, on favor, on favor, on favor. In the mighty name of Jesus, you're going to lay your right hand upon your head. Say, Father, baptize me with favor from on high. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. Lord, baptize me with favor, supernatural favor from on high. Baptize me. Berisa, Ikaliba, Nokosuda, Rikutu Lele Bunta, Linka Sinakonta Rigabus. In the name of Jesus, begin to just thank the Lord, God of answered us. Men de hiko susa haya. Barada kikeleke mena konkoto on barada kisi. Onam tarete favor, Lord, of up right now. Bene salangata la brute kis. Jile le kisi namanda. Thank you, Lord. The Lord of answered our prayers. We will sing praises to you. Answer it, amen. Bless your hand, let me pray. The Lord will answer our prayer. We will sing praises to him. Answer it, amen. Lord, we believe, we trust you that you will never forsake us nor leave us alone. Let, O God, this miracle of favor be established in our life. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare that you compare men we know not to be a blessing to us. In the name of Jesus, thank you, my God and my Father, for in Jesus' name have we pray. Amen. Congratulations. Please send us a testimony. Let us hear what God have done through this divine favor, because you are choosing by favor. All right. Now, if you want to, in fact, you should be giving a offering. Not that if you want to. All right. Then it's a good fat grant to sow. All right. So if you want to give your offering to this ministry or a title or a special seed, our banking date is going to display on the screen. All right. Please don't waste time right now to see the number displays or the account banking display. If you're South Africa, that's one in South Africa going to use Standard Bank. If you are in Nigeria or western part of West Africa, you could use the guarantee trouble. But if you don't live in those region, you can just go to our website and go to place called donate. There's a portal there that's you're going to follow the instruction and drop your offering. As we receive your offering, we're going to get a notification, and we will be praying for you that your hands will not go down in the name of Jesus, because the hands that give always remain at the top. your hand will remain at the top. In the name of Jesus. Let me pray for you. Offering, Father, bless this offering as they drop it right now. In the name of Jesus. We declare God abundance to them, favor for them. In the name of Jesus. The money they didn't labor for will be given to them. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for even the grace for them to give. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be God. In Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord said to me that I speak to you that those who are giving this offering say, the blessing of Abraham is coming upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But please, as we round off this telecast this Sunday, go to Amazon, some of our books are there, or Google Play Store, there are some of our books are there, another platform you could get our books. I believe they're going to display on the screen as well. Just get our books and just begin to read. A reader is a leader. Don't just think I only listen. No, you need to read. You need to read. You can get a hard copy or a Kindle version of it and just begin to read. As you do that, may the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you in the name of Jesus. Now, and we're in the season of favor, this month of favor, so don't miss any of the month. And please do rebroadcast this message, all right, pack people, and let them be blessed. Those who they've lost so before, hope is coming to them in the name of Jesus. But yet, it's no matter what matters, know that the same God is still at work in your life. I see you again, and that time, I say to you, cha-cha. Hallelujah.